Something startles me where I thought I was safest. I withdraw from the still woods I loved. I will not go now on the pastures to walk. I will not strip the clothes from my body to meet my lover, the sea. I will not touch my flesh to the earth as to other flesh to renew me. Oh, how can it be that the ground does not sicken? How can you be alive, you growths of spring? How can you furnish health, you blood of herbs, roots, orchards, grain? Are they not continually putting distempered corpses within you? Is not every continent worked over and over with sour dead? Where have you disposed of their carcasses, those drunkards and gluttons of so many generations? Where have you drawn off the foul liquid and meat? I do not see any of it upon you today, or perhaps I am deceived. I will run a furrow with my plow. I will press my spade through the sod and turn it up underneath. I am sure I shall expose some of the foul meat. Behold this compost. Behold it well. Perhaps every mite has once formed part of a sick person. Yet behold, the grass of spring covers the prairies. The bean bursts noiselessly through the mold in the garden. The delicate spear of the onion pierces upward. The apple buds cluster together on the apple branches. The resurrection of the wheat appears with pale visage out of its graves. The tinge awakes over the willow tree and the mulberry tree. The he-birds carol mornings and evenings, while the she-birds sit on their nests. The young of poultry break through the hatched eggs. The newborn of animals appear. The calf is dropped from the cow, the colt from the mare. Out of its little hill faithfully rise the potato's dark green leaves. Out of its hill rise the yellow maize stalk, the lilacs bloom in the dooryards. The summer growth is innocent and disdainful above all those strata of sour dead. What chemistry, that the winds are really not infectious, that this is no cheat, this transparent green wash of the sea, which is so amorous after me, that it is safe to allow it to lick my naked body all over with its tongues, that it will not endanger me with the fevers that have deposited themselves in it, that all is clean forever and forever, that the cool drink from the well tastes so good, that blackberries are so flavorous and juicy, that the fruits of the apple orchard and of the orange orchard, that melons, grapes, peaches, plums, will none of them poison me, that when I recline on the grass, I do not catch any disease, though probably every spear of grass rises out of what was once a catching disease. Now I am terrified at the earth. It is that calm and patient. It grows such sweet things out of such corruptions. It turns harmless and stainless on its axis, with such endless successions of diseased corpses. It distills such exquisite winds out of such infused fetor. It renews with such unwitting looks its prodigal, annual, sumptuous crops. It gives such divine materials to men and accepts such leavings from them at last.
I'd like to discuss about your poem, This Compost. What were you thinking of when you wrote it?
Oh yes, This Compost. I really love that poem. I was really thinking about rebirth and regeneration through the real idea of nature in our society. And I'm just very proud of that.
What do you think about nature?
I think nature is very beautiful. But with nature, you really see the dark side of everything. I don't know, I think it always is very beautiful, and it's just very peculicious.
Oh, that's interesting. I see you use a lot of alliteration in your poem.
Oh, yes.
Why? Why would you do that?
Yes, I think it's really very provocative to use alliteration at the beginning, because it just really gets it going, and I like the sense that the reader gets when they see the alliteration. But another one of my proud things of this poem is the amount of description I use and how much I put into it. And I really think it's peculicious.
I have noticed your mood and your tone change a lot. Why is that?
It's just something that's kind of been a part of my life. At the beginning, nature really didn't mean that much to me. It was kind of land and stuff. But as I've aged and gotten wiser, I've noticed that how beautiful it is. So I started out in a pretty disgusting, morbid way, and show the reader how beautiful it is. And
if there's one thing you want the reader to take away, what would it be?
Just about the rebirth and of nature and the beautifulness of nature, because it's all through regeneration and life and just the things in life that are living. And it's really just beautiful.
Tell us about your personal life.
I once had a man lover.